It was a crunch. I kept saying I'm staying in touch. But that thing went bust, so I gave it up. Ooh, no tricks, no bluff. I'm just better off without them cuffs. Yeah, the sun won't set on us. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Yeah! When low and high, still waters run dry. Gotta get back in the groove. I never wondered. When low and high, what matters is now. Get right back in the mood. I live my day as if it was the last. Live my day.
Hi Leo, welcome back to your weekly reading. So I channeled that song for you today, and it was by Zara Larsson, and it's called Lush Life. So I hope you guys are all good. I've missed your energy. Yes, so let's see what God and my guides have for you today. So what messages do you have today, please, God, for Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and Lord Loki? Here in still waters run dry. I'm hearing we're all here. So I'm getting you've got a lot of angels in your energy field. Someone's trying to guide you. That's what I'm picking up here. And I'm also hearing a choice between two. And I heard that in the song. It's like you've given up on a crush energy. Someone that you wanted to fall in love with you. Maybe you've been trying to manifest this person or attract them into your life. That's what I'm picking up here. But this person doesn't seem to notice your existence. That's what I'm hearing. I'm also picking up there's another crush energy that you're looking into right now. Yeah, so you may have a choice between two, because I'm picking up when you stopped looking at this first crush, that's when they'll come in. Crazy but true. So I'm picking up you might have a choice between two here. I'm hearing like rhymes. So you might be some sort of singer, some sort of poet, or someone who just likes music, or you might be hearing songs. I'm hearing that too. I feel like this other person's being guided towards you, or you're being guided towards them. And it's because this other crush energy was not interested or was not paying any attention to you. But I'm picking up, like I said, once you stop manifesting this first crush, that's when they'll come into your energy. So you may have a choice between two people. This could be two men, two women. Take it out, it resonates. There's no gender. Okay. So let's see what comes out. I'm getting a slow process here. So you've been crushing on someone for a long time. Here in 10 months here. So you might have put 10 months of, you know, just envisioning someone, thinking about them, you know, even smiling at this person if you see them. That's what I'm picking up here. Or trying to get their attention in some sort of way, because I feel like you're someone who's like always partying or always out there in, you know, in the scene. I'm hearing on the scene. This could be on social media too. It could be someone you look at on social media. You know, you're someone you post regularly. I'm hearing Snapchat, I'm hearing Instagram stories. This person might watch your stories quite a lot, but they never comment. They're just always in the, you know, the viewed section, I'm hearing. So this person, you know, they could be shy, or they could just be someone who's like quite standoffish here. Or, you know, they could have their eye on somebody completely different here. But I feel like you've given up on this person, but that's when, you know, they'll mysteriously come into your energy. Yeah, you might have been trying to call this person in spiritually. That's what I'm picking up. You could have been sending them songs, synchronicities. You know, this person isn't tapped in. That's what I'm picking up. So they haven't received your messages. They don't even kind of know that you like them. That's what I'm picking up here. You kind of held on to, you know, this crush energy for some time. I see you holding your heart when you see a picture of this person. Or you might see them in your local town. I'm seeing like a temple here. This person could be religious, or you could be religious. That's what I'm picking up here. What I'm picking up, this person's quite narcissistic here. Oh, there's two cards there. Wow. So I feel like this person has been watching you secretly too. But like I said, I'm picking up like a narcissistic kind of vibe here. It's like this person, you know, they'll make you watch until the end of time because they're getting some sort of supply or some sort of boost, I'm hearing, from you watching them. They know you like them and they'll leave you hanging or hanging on forever because, you know, you're an empath sort of energy. That's what I'm picking up here. I'm picking up empress vibes here too. But this person's a narc, that's why, you know, they haven't batted an eyelid in your direction. They know you're watching them, that's what I'm picking up here. But they're not tapped into that spiritual vibe. They're more 3D, more, you know, grandiose energy, more me vibe. So, you know, they're the type who wants you to follow them to the end of the earth and they'll still, you know, reject you. That's what I'm picking up here. This person, you know, they don't want to know about spirituality or spiritual connections here. So they're just completely not interested or not paying any interest. That's what I'm picking up here. I'm picking up a fake energy here. This person's not real. They may look like everything. I'm hearing a God's send or God's gift. I'm also hearing God complex. This person thinks, you know, women should bow to them or run to them or, you know, keep on, you know, pressing their energy because they get an energy boost every time they see, you know, an attractive female looking at them. I feel like this person deep down has a million insecurities, a million flaws. You know, they're someone who, you know, they secretly don't like themselves, and that's why, you know, they get some sort of boost out of having your attention on them all the time. So I'm picking up that you're quite a beautiful girl. It's someone who could be, you know, someone's wife. I'm hearing wife material here, and this person knows that. But they're so, I'm hearing, up their own arse here. Yeah, this person, you know, they're just, you know, it's like almost like they're vain, like they're always looking in the mirror at themselves and, you know, they just think they're God's gift or, you know, they think that they can control the situation by acting like a God. Yeah, so you've been hoping, you've been wishing, you've been praying and, you know, anticipating on the future with this person, hoping they notice you, hoping they'll choose you, hoping, you know, they're attracted to you too. But I'm picking up this person's only attraction is to their self. That's what I'm hearing here. And we got the Hunter card in reverse. This person wants you to follow them, hunt them down, constantly go through a cycle where you're constantly looking for this person or trying to mirror their energy. They get some sort of thrill out of watching you. I'm getting like, you know, and a puppy, you know, shakes a paw kind of energy and they bow down first before they lift up their paw. They want someone like that following them around like a lovesick up here. That's what I'm hearing here. But you have a high honor here. You're someone who, you know, God sent you into this person's energy because you were supposed to be with this person. That's what I'm hearing here. But this person, you know, they took that kind of, you know, superior road where they think, you know, women should fall at their feet. That's what I'm hearing here. And you know, this isn't what God expected of this person. You know, God expected this person to recognize you on a soul level. God lit the way for you and this person to come into contact with each other. This could be, you know, some sort of star, or you could be a star. That's what I'm hearing as well. And you know, you've just been trying and trying and trying to manifest this person who, you know, he's too, you know, snooty or snobby, I'm hearing, to even notice your existence. That's what I'm picking up. Or they do, like I said, notice you, and they get a thrill out of seeing that sort of attention from you. I feel like, you know, God has given you another chance with someone else here. God is sending somebody else, someone better, into your energy. Someone with the same values, standards, morals, you know, the same respect. I'm hearing equal reciprocity. That's what I'm picking up here. So this could be the second crush energy. And my battery might die, so, you know, I'll just fit in what I can here. So, I feel like you could be some sort of dancer, or you could be, like I said, you're always out partying and dancing. This person watches you, but you've got a lot of angels watching over you too, and they're trying to guide you in a different direction, because I feel like you became obsessed with this person, and this person was never gonna notice you, or, you know, they just get high off knowing that you're craving their attention. Like I said, this person has some sort of grandiose sort of energy here. Yeah, so I feel like you could have like a blocked crown chakra, and that's why you held on for so long. But it could have put you into like a mental sort of prison. You felt tied down, you felt held back, you felt like this person was never gonna come in. So it did play with your emotions quite a lot. I see a lot of like anxiety, waiting, hoping, wishing, praying that this person would notice you. I'm seeing weed here as well, so I'm getting someone here smokes weed. Could be this person. I'm seeing hella, you know, joints. I'm seeing a lot of spliffs. This person gets high quite a lot here, and you know, they're all about themselves. That's what I'm picking up here. I feel like this was, you know, supposed to be some sort of gift that God was giving to this person. But, you know, there was no equal balance here. This person brought you down more than up. That's what I'm picking up here. And with the Libra sort of energy here, I feel like there was some sort of imbalance here. Like you're giving too much to this connection, but you're kind of not receiving the same. And you want equal reciprocity from someone, whether it's a glance, a look, a smile, you know, even a relationship here. That's what I feel like you was craving for some time. Could have even had visions of marriage. You know, I do see you trying to manifest this person quite a lot, envision them, call them in spiritually. I see you sending songs, signs, angel numbers to this person. But you know, this person, you know, they treat you like a burden, or they're the type who, you know, they'll sit down and smoke with you or have a smoking session and then just say, oh, I've got to go, and act like you're more of a friend. So they could have friend zoned you quite a few times here. That's what I'm picking up here. So you kept working harder and harder and harder to get this person's attention. That's what I'm picking up. But you found yourself in this single energy for a long time. You found that you was focusing on this person more more than living your own life, more than having fun, or, you know. So you started to do that, you started to enjoy yourself and forget about this person because you feel like it's not equal, like this person could be two-faced, or this person doesn't have the same attraction, or this is not, you know, real love, you know. Real love, that's what I'm picking up. I don't feel like this is, I feel like this is, you know, unrequited love situation. This person just wants your full attention. They get a thrill, they feel, you know, special. That's what I'm picking up. They want you to keep liking, watching, you know, posting them, or, you know, messaging or commenting on their social media. I'm hearing that as well. This person notices that you're always in their inbox, or you're always, you know, you're on their feed. I'm seeing that as well. Or you could just be the first one to like a picture they post, or a video. I'm picking that up too. I feel like this person was stealing your energy. I'm hearing siphoning your energy, because they enjoy, you know, using women with their posture, with their grace, with their, you know, they're good looking, they could be handsome, they could be pretty. You know, this person enjoys stealing that bit of energy, that bit of attention that you give to them. I'm seeing you longingly staring at this person, and this person looks the opposite way, but deep down they know that you're looking at them, but they're too, you know, hearing up their own arse again. My guides aren't playing. This is a dark energy who kind of manipulates their victims. That's what I'm picking up here. You want a family sort of guy. You want someone who wants the same values, morals, you know, look and love as you. You could have a lot of money too, or that's them. I feel like you're supposed to be like God's gift to this person, but this person took advantage of you, turned away, or turned a blind eye. I'm hearing that as well. But I do feel like this person's heavily manipulating you, or using some sort of, you know, mental mind magic, I'm hearing, or mental play to kind of bring you down, ignore and avoid you. I'm hearing avoidant. So this person knows how to play with energy. They know how to manipulate. They know how to make you, you know, stare at them even longer, or, you know, just get your attention. They know you'll be there. They know you'll be watching them, or, you know, trying to grab their attention. But I feel like God's putting this person down for you, because this person's no good here. This person loves to play people off against each other, and that's their vibe, that's their energy. You know, they're not focused like you are, or maybe this is that you've lost kind of focus since you've been watching them, and you're starting to realize, you know, there's better out there. That's what I'm picking up for you. So I do see God giving you another try with someone new. This is a new energy, someone who, you know, is about to ask you on a date, because this person, you know, they've noticed that you look at them too, you're attracted to them too. I do feel like this person was sent to you from God, and it's because you've been battling to get this Knight of Pentacles in reverse's energy, this bad energy, this bad blood, this bad spirit. That's what I'm hearing here. This person wants you to fight over them. This person could possibly want you to buy weed and invite them to smoke it. So they could use you quite a lot here. I do see you spending quite a lot of money with this person. They could be a drug dealer. I'm picking that up too. And you keep calling them for more weed just to see them. So I feel like God's, you know, he's giving you another chance with somebody new here, someone better. This is judgment. God's calling judgment on this person who keeps manipulating, keeps on trying to, you know, to press your energy. That's what I'm picking up. You might feel drained after partying with this person, or you might feel drained after, you know, partying and seeing this person out. I feel like this person continuously drops you like a hat. It's like, you know, they leave you out in the cold. They could ignore you. You leave the club at the end of the night and this person jumps in their car and drives off and ignores you. This person, you know, there's someone, you know, I don't even feel like they like women. This is like a misogynistic kind of energy. You know, if it's a woman, you know, it's someone who has like a father kind of issue. I'm picking that up too. They don't like that. You know, they don't like anyone. That's what I'm picking up. They just, you know, they like to torment people. I mean, use people, or could possibly just like to smoke all the time, or just like to use people for sex. And this is the truth with the Ace of Swords. But at the same time, you're being gifted with someone who would take that step towards you, who would make that step, who would give you, you know, a ring here. So you have a big choice coming up here. Do you want the weird man, or do you want the true love energy? So there's, you know, it's like these two cards are mirroring each other. There's one, like, one that just wants to smoke and have sex with you and use you because they know that, you know, you wish to be with them. And then there's one that would marry you, protect you, love you, would send songs, signs, synchronicities towards you. So it's like, you know, you have, you know, a decision to make. Will you pick, you know, I'm hearing God or Satan here. So, you know, choose wisely, because one of them drains the fuck out of you and the other one, you know, could take you away on a holiday, on a trip to another country and move in with you. I'm getting that as well, as someone who, you know, would spend, you know, their whole life with you. I'm hearing like till death do us part kind of energy. This other person would be by your side, would create a family, would love your family and you would love theirs, would build a home, a legacy, a solid, stable environment together. I'm seeing like an end to you, you know, longing for this other person, this narc energy. I see you cutting them off. This isn't real love. This isn't real commitment. Even if you slept with them, they've used you because they're a player and, you know, ignored you afterwards. There's better for you. With the Ten of Cups here, there's someone who will emotionally fulfill you, someone who's waiting for someone just like you, someone who's been sent into your energy. So you might be seeing a lot of signs, song synchronicities about this person, and I feel like a confused energy, like you thought the first person was your twin or your ideal match. But I'm picking up this person's even better. That's what I'm seeing here. This is someone, you know, who wants someone who's pure and innocent as you, who's loving, fully committed, you know, someone who has emotions. This person's heading in your direction real fast. If you haven't seen them already, you're about to bump into this new crush energy. And, you know, this could be when you go away somewhere. You could go on a trip, a holiday, abroad, I'm hearing. You might be planning to go away soon on a vacation, or you might just take a trip somewhere and you're going to see this person. But I do see you having fun and living your life, because you've been trapped in a karmic never-ending cycle with someone who's quite bitter and, you know, I just keep being grandiose and misogynistic. So, you know, this other person would probably, you know, trap you into this cycle forever, like keep you there, keep haunting your spirit or your energy or playing with your vibration. I'm hearing that as well. I feel like this person enjoys seeing the rejection on your face, and you know, there's someone better here. There's someone who's going to love the bones off you. That's what I'm picking up here. You know, this other person, they just want to sleep with you and move on, sleep with you, get you pregnant and leave you in the alleyway. This other guy, this new crush, is a new positive change that God is sending towards you. Look, God orchestrated this. This is the God card, the Hierophant. He sent someone else into your energy. He's given another DM or another DF, I'm hearing, a chance with you, because you're real, you're pure, you're one of God, you're protected. This other guy now has lost their chance. That's what I'm picking up here. And this is like a decision that you have to make. But if you look at the pros and the cons here, they're all for this new person coming into your life. So, you know, it's a good thing that you stop manifesting. It's a good thing that you stood still here, you know, giving this person a stalemate energy, because they don't deserve you. There's someone that will, you know, woo you, romance you, serenade, and, you know, marry you in the end. That's what I'm picking up here. Yeah, I see a marriage with the Queen of Pentacles. This person, you know, they will do what they gotta do to get you into their life, to attract you. But I do see a mutual attraction. When you see this person, you will know. You will know it's them. That's what I'm picking up here. And I did say I saw the Empress. So, you know, this person will see you as wife material, see you as, you know, their baby mother kind of energy, someone they would get pregnant, love, adore, look after. That's what I'm picking up here. Whereas that other person would just get you pregnant if they haven't done already and leave you behind. So you've got a choice between two here. Would you like the bad boy who never changes, or are you gonna go for that good guy who's going to be a blessing from the Most High? And I'm going to leave it there. Okay, so I hope this message helps you. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe. And if you'd like a personal reading, please check the description box below. Okay, so bye guys.